Everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we are going to do a succulent update. As close as we are getting to the plant sale, we need to start moving some more succulents into pots. So that's what we're going to be doing today, and then we're going to show you how the ones we did before are looking. If you saw our succulent video from a couple of weeks ago, we potted those little ones that you saw out in the other room and put them in clusters as well as individuals. And all but two of them seem to be doing well. We don't know why these guys are looking the way they are, but we'll dig them out and see what they look like and maybe just take off some of the tops. But the rest of them look lovely. Now, these two, you knew that we were having trouble with those, and I haven't given up on those yet, so we'll just nurse them along. The ones in the trucks are doing very nicely, and the ones in the pots, I keep turning them so that they are evenly lighted.
Well, you have them in the south window too, so
yes.
That's
plus I have three grow lights on them, so yeah. They look very, very nice.
Well, you move others throughout the house, too. I notice you have some on the dining room table as well. But I really like this little cluster. I thought that
this is very
that turned
cute.
Out so nicely.
Yes.
Has a nice variety of colors. I don't know that they show up as bright and as colorful on camera.
But this one looks very cute, too.
Yeah.
And I like the ones that just stand by themselves. Like this one is so cool in its own little pot.
Yeah.
And this one is so neat. But this plant in particular is just luscious.
Yeah, I like that one a lot.
I'm not going to bore you by showing you how I'm doing each single one, but I'll start with the basics. I'm just starting with a pot. This one has a little screen in the bottom. I'll put some pea gravel in there for added drainage and for weight, just to stabilize the container. Then I'm going to add my potting mix that is for cactus, palm, and citrus. So it's a special blend. So then I'm going to put some of that in.
You blend?
I blend, and I use blend.
And you're not even Marissa Tomei?
And then we've decided that this beauty, one of our all-time favorites, is going to be the one that's going in that pot. Okay, you can see how beautiful that is. And you can see how dry the bottom is, which is one of the reasons we don't want to overwater them, but we didn't want to dry them all out so that they dry up and die on us. So I'm just breaking up the soil a little bit around the bottom. And I'm going to dig a little pit for it, and then I will put the potting mix around it. And this pot will give this little succulent a good base to grow in. Lots of room. You can get nice and tall.
Well, that helps stabilize it, too.
Yes.
But more importantly, it surrounds the roots so the roots don't dry out.
Exactly. So I'm just going to put a little bit more in here.
More brownie mix, huh?
Mm-hmm. And then firm it down, but not pound it down. So that's our plan for the rest of this. This is pea gravel. I'm going to sprinkle some of that like I did at the on the bottom. I'm going to put some around the top. It just makes it look more like a desert, doesn't it? Now, if you wanted, you could add some larger pebbles or some figurines or whatever makes you think of the desert or makes you happy. But for right now.
Well, that's what you did last time.
Yes, we did. I've been on my way planting. Planning out what goes in what pot. So while I think I have the majority of them done, and I've tried to combine some, I still have a few left, but my little Ricky's getting hungry, so it's time to make supper. You can see it's getting dark outside, so I'll take a little break and make supper, and then I'll be back. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd truly appreciate that. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, there's that little button over there. We'd love to hear your comments and your questions. Bye for now.
I'm getting hungry.
I bet you are.
Connect with us on YouTube.